I'm putting the finishing touch on the SPX cylinder, and I thought I'd give you a little tour of my porting setup. Many of you have been asking for longer videos. Tomorrow might be the day, because I'm starting on the new SPX rotary valve intake cover with my limited tools. That might take a while, so stay tuned. If you're just going to do the occasional port job on your own stuff, then efficiency and time spent and even reliability isn't that big of a deal. What I mean is, you don't have to splurge out thousands of dollars on fancy tools from places like CC Specialty, even though I've heard their tools are excellent. Never heard anything but good words about them. And if you are running a small business or porting a lot for friends, their tools are probably worth the money. Here's my very affordable, yet very functional setup. First up is the Dremel knockoff with flex shaft, all important flex shaft. You have to use this flex shaft. If you use just a Dremel, it will die in a matter of maybe hours, even minutes. Bearings get loaded or it dust in the motor or something. I don't know exactly why, but my experience is that if you use this tool without the flex shaft, it won't last you long. I've had this one for several years and I've used it a lot and it's still running fine. Buy a cheap Dremel knockoff with a flex shaft and never use it without the flex shaft. I'm using it with this DIY right angle tool I've made. If you want more info on that one, check out my do-it-yourself porting tools videos, and there's some info on how I built it and what it's made out of. It actually works great. I am going to get a second one of this tool and use it with just the straight handpiece. That way I won't have to take off the right angle tool each time I want to use this. Next up is the China dental tool from eBay, Marathon. So if you search for Marathon dental tool on eBay, you will find a lot of variations on this thing. It's basically just a voltage supply with some variable speed control and direction control. And attached is a motor. You can use it with a right angle tool. That right angle tool is the reason you will buy this one in the first place. You can also use it with a straight tool. The straight tool is actually working pretty great. It's holding up fine. I've used it a lot. The right angle tool is hit and miss. The last one I had lasted for maybe 5 minutes and the bevel gears inside got chewed up. This one has actually lasted for several hours, so hit and miss, but they're cheap. Buy five and maybe two of them are okay and it's worth it. I use several types of bits. Mostly I use these carbide burrs in various shapes. I have some stones, but they load up with aluminium pretty fast, and when they do, they have a tendency to explode. I rarely use them, they're not very useful. I have a bunch of files, small files and larger files, diamond files, bent files, and a bunch of diamond burrs in various shapes and forms. They are great for precise work and also great for cutting glass. For the eBay dental tool, I've made several small sanding drums and also some flappers, thanks to Holleindaren, which convinced me they were great for porting, and they are. They leave a pretty good finish. I also have these tiny burrs meant for the tool. They're not that useful, they're so small and they have a tendency to dig in and mark the cylinder. Sandpaper in various grits and some sanding pads which conform to the surface you're sanding. They are nice for taking off burrs on the top edge of the cylinder and around the skirts and stuff like that. Eye protection, yep, I've started wearing eye protection. A lot of light. Light is important. It's especially nice to have a flexible lamp like this, both from IKEA, because then you can point it upwards into the cylinder and still reach in there with your tool. And this makes it much easier to spot the line you're working up against. Okay, that's it for now. Thanks for watching. Stay tuned for the next video, which will be a longer one. I will be test fitting the SPX cylinder on the case, checking how much I will have to space it up, and I will start making the new rotary valve intake cover. Please subscribe, share my videos, and I'll see you next time.